Welcome to Let's Play Gran Turismo 4 Part 100. Yeah, it's not really a milestone, but fuck it. I don't even know. So, for this next series, which you know is going to be in the title, I'm going to drive a car I haven't driven yet in this game. This LP. Mazda Speed 6. Gonna get in this little fucker. Bam. And, going to see what kind of tires this thing has. Alright, sports medium. That's exactly what I wanted, actually. So, huzzah. So, medium sports tire. You know what? Just because of how long these races are. They're not, like, long, but they're about... Oh, I don't know, the GT All-Stars long. So I'll just buy the sport hard compounds just in case. But I'm gonna keep the mediums equipped for this first race, at least. That is the home, not the extreme events, god damn it me. Let's try this again. Extreme events, thank you. And the Polyphony Digital Cup. 10 more races, $200,000 winner's prize. And yeah, so here we go. Let's just get started with our first race, which is going to be at Motegi. Okay, so the Mazda was not good enough for this. Shit. So let's try something else. If I even have something else here that I haven't driven, isn't retardedly powerful. Oh, that's the pace car. Fuck that. fuck it. Let's see what I have just overall here. I could use the RS200. It's got good power to weight. Probably. Nah. NSX. What else do I have here? Use my Mercury Cougar again, haha. Hey, it's RX-8. I don't think I actually used this, I just kind of tried it. Oh wait, I used it, 43 miles on it, okay. Do I want to use the NSX again? Eh, fuck it, let's go with the NSX. Let's try this out. It has a... It's probably a little better than that Mazda. Hopefully it's better enough. Doesn't really make sense, but you know what I mean. So let's just buy the hard tires just in case, but not equip them, and back to Motegi. And of course the field of cars is different, and the game doesn't give me... The car that gave me trouble last time is not here, aka the Nissan Fairlady Z, like S-Tune or some shit. The Supra maybe give me something, I don't fucking know. And before this is just a fucking cakewalk now, because the game gave me different, you know, different opposition. I'm gonna keep my eye on that Supra though. It's gonna be easy to keep my eye on him because he's starting right in front of me. Ha ha ha. So, let's go. 6 laps around Motegi. Back in my NSX. And I make the easy pass around the Supra. So yeah, there's your tone for the series. Easy. Maybe. Also have, well, the S2000 is not a deal, and looks like the Audi S3 up there is not going to be a problem either. I love when I prepare for something and the game gives me worse. Like, oh, you failed that? Well, here, let me turn on easy mode. Oh, shit. Well, that went well. That was fucking lovely. Hey, how you doing, Mr. S2000? Fuck off with your shit, yo. Really like these headlamps on this car. Alright, well, I guess I'm gonna dominate this series now, since the game is taking pity on me. Piece of shit. Yeah, I don't see that Supra being an issue. He's still in fucking last place. So let's see, S2000's going for second on the Audi. And I can't see anything else behind me. Oh shit. Way late on the brakes. Oopsie. I done fucked up. Well, there's one lap complete. Very shitty lap, but it was... yeah. I think I might switch to hard compound tires for the rest of the series just to make it a little less shitty. It'll be shittier for me, but you know. Less shitty for you. I'm surprised I didn't shift down the first gear there. My finger kind of had a spasm. Aw. Hey, remember this site? Aw, shit. Fucking select button, why are you so sensitive? Also, really like how the body roll is really present on the bumper cam. You can see it so well, and it fucking fucks with me a lot. Especially on, like, more practical cars, this is kind of a sporty car. Because, you know, it isn't an SX. It's the fucking R model as well. And this thing does not have as good brakes as that Mazda. That Mazda 6 was actually pretty damn good. Just didn't have the power to hold up to the frickin' Nissan. That fair lady. This probably wouldn't have the power to hold up to it either, but... fuck. Trying to remember what my lap times were in the Mazda. I think they're better than this. I think I was running 211s in it. Oh, suddenly I have a 15-second lead. Well then. Thought the S2000 was going to do something, but no. Did not. Alrighty. Well then. Aw, shit. Well, may not be racing any more production cars in Forza, but still getting them here. And, the next leg of the LP, you're really gonna get them. There's your hint at what I'm doing next. I'm so far ahead. It's a little stupid. I wonder where the Supra is. There's a decent lap. Yeah, this thing is better than the Mazda 6. Once I, you know, actually figure out how to drive it. I am half a minute ahead. God damn it. I really hate when the game trolls me like this. Fucking shit. It's like, hey, make this a close hard fight against the Nissan. Oh no. Make this an absolute blowout instead. So yeah, the hard tires will slow me down a bit, but not nearly enough to make this interesting. Still gonna go with them, but, you know. Should've bought comfort tires. Because haha, no grip. Whatsoever. I'm gonna win by over a minute. I just know it. Doo-doo, new fast lap, and two to go. Still have a fight for fourth place kind of going on. Other than that, everybody's really spread the fuck out. Just the overall AI choices for this series are just not cool. Because it just becomes, you know, not really crazy interesting shit. It's just everybody spread the fuck out. Still really surprised at the Supra's lack of performance. I'm really expecting it to be one of the heavy hitters, but no. Just is not. Oh shit, no, no, get out of the gravel. Alright, one more lap around Motegi. So weird not just having just pure speed out of everywhere. Those fucking, you know. Yeah. Big race cars and shit. Man, almost a minute ahead. Like I said, I'm gonna win by a fucking minute. Aw, shit. Late on the brakes. Really close to lapping the last place car. That fight for fourth place is still going on. Late entry. Final turn. Am I gonna reach him before the line? And just barely not. But there we go. I take victory in the first of 10 very, very, very easy races. Because fuck you, game. Man, Supra is still in fifth. Holy shit. Maybe he has the power and he just keeps making mistakes. I don't fucking know. All I know is this segment and the two following ones are not going to be that interesting because of the absolute dominance. But I'm going to switch to the hard compound tires to make this at least a little less of a blowout to race two. Our second race is going to be at Seattle. Haven't been here in a while. Reverse course. Haven't been here in a while in an actual race. Did that one driving mission, but yeah. Actually quite a somewhat large number of courses in this game that this shit happens. It's like, oh hey, this place, I haven't been here in like 5 years. Oh shit. See if the Supra can do something here. Since the only off course you're gonna get is the wall. And out of bounds if you manage to clip out. I actually watched a video, and that is possible around the Nürburgring. It's very silly and kind of random, but the trick is there, and the out of bounds is retarded. Oh, lay on the brakes. So at least try to pass this S2000 cleanly. I said cleanly. I can just sandbag behind him and rear-end him for the fucking eternity. I'm just gonna push him. Fuck it. Him down here and make it look spectacular. Whee! Damn, fucking... The car did a massive nosedive, which is weird because it's a mid-engine car. You'd think the weight would be balanced a little better. But no, fucking nosedive. I forgot to switch tires. I just realized this. Fuck me. I was too eager to get the race started. I fucking my wonderful short-term memory failed me yet again. And I already have a 6-second lead. Yoink. Shit. Ugh. I think I kissed the wall there. I think. Alright, let's do another nosedive. Yeah. This is late on the brakes, fuck. Alrighty, well, that's two laps complete. I'm sure I have like a 15-second lead already. Smack. Oh, I underestimated it. 17 seconds. Excuse the fuck out of me. That in. Shit wall, yep. Definitely got it that time. Whoa, a little drift there. Just a little too aggressive. This is going to be well over a minute victory. Don't wall, I hit the wall. And then hit that wall. Yeah, half a minute ahead after three laps, with four to go. Definitely gonna win by over a minute. Looks like the Supra is still stuck in fifth place, so the disappointment continues. do halfway through the race. Three to go. Smack. Cool. It'd be cool if I could go around that chicane at least once without hitting the wall on the exit. At least I'm hitting the outside wall, not the fucking... Yeah. The bad walls. Time. Fucking shit. Can't take that too slow. Oopsie. Ooh, I kept it off the ball, holy shit. It's a fucking miracle. Also, I'm definitely going to lap at least one car. Well, yeah, it's gonna be just one car. That frickin' Peugeot or whatever is in last. Hey, look, there he is. Didn't just let me squeak by, he had to hit me. And the lead's almost a minute, holy shit. Lap around Seattle. Okay, at least it didn't royally fuck up the chicane through all seven laps. That's nice. I was fully expecting to do that, especially with my with this view now. My inability to properly judge where to place my car. No, kept it clean for the most part. So, huzzah. Oh, look, I'm over a minute ahead. Holy shit. fucking front of the car just noses down. Big fucking dive. Oh shit, wall. Hey, there's the Supra, still in fifth fucking place. Looks like I'm gonna lap him. You disappoint me, son. Thought you were better than that, but no, you're not. There we go, race two complete. A new fast lap on the last lap, fuck yeah.
So hopefully I'll remember to switch to the hard compound tires, even though it's not gonna make a goddamn bit of difference
for the next race. And yeah. So it looks like there isn't gonna be any issues with the points as far as shaking anything up. So relatively simple series for an extreme event. By simple I mean stupid. But whatever. So let's go to race 3 now. And race 3 takes us to the Sonoma Stock NASCAR course. And I did remember to put the hard compound tires on this time. It's not going to make much of enough of a difference, but it's going to make a little bit of a difference. It makes 1 point of a difference. Alright, I'm going to shut my fucking mouth now. Yeah, I didn't really expect it to make much of a difference, but I don't fucking know. Anyways, 8 laps around Sonoma. So here we go, get around the Pojo first. This little ass motherfucker. Get around the disappointment that is the Supra. RX-7. Then Audi, I believe, what is it, S3? Aw. Something like that, A3, S3 something. And finally, the S2000. Take it easy over the S's. Power around the S2000. Ugh. There's one lap. I'm not 17,000 seconds ahead, at least. Only two. That two is going to turn into a lot more. I'm pretty sure I've mentioned this before, because that's usually what I do, but I wonder why NASCAR stopped going around the carousel around here. Like, that is a legitimate inquiry, damn it. Okay, that sand wasn't as unforgiving as I thought it was going to be. But yeah, I wonder why they stopped racing around the carousel around here and just took that straight path. Boggles the main. Not really sure why I downshifted there, but whatever. Over the big-ass fucking curbs. No. Just kind of said that to say something. Break the silence. Three laps complete. Wonder how many years I am ahead of the S2000. Of course, this isn't nearly as bad as the 1,000 Miles Championship, but no, I don't think anything can be as bad as that. Seconds. Yeah, just fucking, this is only going to be like not even 3 hours of absolute domination, as opposed to 10 hours of insane domination. So yeah, there's that. Halfway through the race here at Sonoma. I use the term race very loosely. More of a Sunday drive. I'll be able to lap Pojo this time. It's looking quite possible, actually. Also, what's this? The fight for fourth is not for fourth, it's for third this time. Probably some off-track shenanigans, knowing the nature of this place and the nature of the AI in this game. Might actually win by just under a minute because of my tire choice. Oh shit. Keep downshifting there, and I really don't need to. S's yet again. A little too quickly. Alright, well, goodbye cones. It was nice knowing you. And yeah, I'm definitely gonna get around the Pojo before the race is over. Oh. Most likely get him this lap. There's the drag strip off to your right. For such a small facility, this actually has quite a bit of differences, like different things. And there's this course that has three different routes, basically. There's the carousel section, and there's also this NASCAR section. Then you have the drag strip, in the, just kind of the middle of everything. As well as this section right here, kind of different places for the hairpin exit and shit. Or just the hairpin in general. We have the S's. And here, you can either go to the right or go to that coned off area for a chicane. So yeah, despite how kind of small this place is overall and how tight everything is, it's got a lot of different routes. I will give it that. Of course, the hairpin here, you don't see it in this game, but there's the shortened hairpin, which kind of just skips that entire straightaway area. So yeah, I think the IndyCars race on that, the shortened hairpin and shit. I know they do the chicane. But yeah, and stuff. Keep going too fast through these two turns. Oh, what the fuck is wrong with me among... Well, there's many things wrong with me, but you know. And we're off in the sand. Well, there's three races down, as soon as I cross the line. Bam. So there's three races down, only seven to go. 11 and a half minutes, shortest race I think so far, as far as time. And yeah. Well, the Supra did beat the RX-7 for fourth place this time, and has been battling with the S3. The Audi S3. So there's that slight change in the standings. Slight. But other than that, business as usual. So let's move on to race number 4. And our fourth and final race of this segment is going to take place at Tokyo Reverse. So here we go. And our first standing start of the series. Let's see how this thing does on the launch. I can't remember. Wheel spin as expected. But not much, since it doesn't have a lot of power. And I'm just gonna fly by everybody. Immediately. Take the lead before the first turn. Lovely. My standing start just made this race a lot easier. I mean, it was already extremely easy to begin with, but could have had at least some excitement in me trying to overtake everybody, but no. Just pass them all before the first turn. Oh, shit. Car was not gripping as well as I thought it was going to be. At least I can take that flat out as long as I do it right. More sliding. Come on, bring it down. There we go. It's like I planned for that to happen. I actually didn't expect to swing out that wide, but I pretty much planned that. around the final turn and into the wall. Because, you know, fuck me. Alright, one lap down, four to go. Brakes, but we're fine. Bonk. Hitting that wall. Man, 11 second lead. Oh, what a fucking shocker. Pretty sure the Supra has gone back to chilling behind the RX-7, because that's what it does, I guess. Although they're really goddamn close to each other. Dim horns. As late on the brakes that time. Probably was, I don't fucking know. Oh, turned in too soon? Fuck. I failed. Fucking car turns in like it's gonna grip through there just fine, and it just doesn't. And it's only in that turn for some reason. It's a really weird feeling. It's like I feel the grip there on the turn in, and then it's just gone. Yes, I feel these things. But anyways, I don't fucking know. Still early on the brakes. Actually hit the curb this time on the apex, so that's nice. Since that's kind of what I'm aiming for that turn. Two laps to go. At Tokyo. Pretty good braking, I think. Therefore, I'm wrong. Alright, I actually made it around there that time. still have the weird loss of grip feeling around there, but kept it off the wall. Turn up immensely. Lovely. Okay, one more lap. Race 4 will be over, and this segment will be over. So I'm splitting this into 3 segments. Because of the race times. Because, you know, I'm a faggot like that. I'm gonna get close to the Peugeot this time. And off the final turn. There we go. It's got to cross the line. I like how little wear I have on my tires. I.e. almost none at all. There we go. Race complete. 4 out of 4. Something tells me this is actually going to be a clean sweep this time. And yep, Supra behind the RX-7. So, way to go, idiot. I don't even know. 16-point lead for me. Huzzah. You know, the minimum point lead I can have after winning all 4 races. So, yeah. Stay tuned for the next 3 races in the next segment and all that shit. So, woo.